How to tag ArtMesh in Live2D Cubism for use with plugins such as CheersBot. You have at least two ways of doing this, but the first method requires access to your model's CMO3 file, which is a Cubism project file. For the first way, open your Cubism project file and select any ArtMesh in your project. You can select multiple ArtMeshes by control-clicking subsequent ArtMeshes and apply the same tag to all of them at once. With the art meshes selected, expand the user data box in the inspector panel. Type in your desired tags and click update. You can also apply multiple tags by entering them on different lines. When you export this model, you will then have access to these art mesh tags in plugins that utilize them, such as CheersBot. This can be really helpful when you want to affect a group of meshes at once, such as tinting your entire hair, so that you don't have to add each mesh individually to a plugin. If you do not have access to your model file but do use VTube Studio, you can apply tags to the user data JSON file. Hawkbar, the creator of CheersBot, created a plugin to do this called the VTube Studio Tagger, which is linked in the description. With VTube Studio open, go into your settings and ensure that Start API is on to allow you to use plugins. You will also need to be sure this is enabled if you want to connect to CheersBot or other VTube Studio plugins. You may need to refresh the VTube Studio tagger after turning the API on. On the tagger, you will want to select your user data JSON file so it knows which file to update. If you don't have one already, it will create one for you. Now, please excuse the fact that I'm about to become very cursed. As you hover over the art mesh in the list, the tagger will highlight it on your model to ensure that you have the correct parts selected. As you can see, I already have some tags that I applied to my actual model file in Cubism for hair. But let's say for this example that I wanted to do it for my sweater. So I will select my sweater parts. On a tangential note, it is always good practice to make sure your art mesh is named correctly, unlike what I have here, where they all are just art mesh with a number. If you are a model artist, ensuring every layer in your PSD file is uniquely named and following Cubism naming requirements for IDs will keep the layer names when importing into Cubism. Cubism art mesh naming requirements can only use letters, numbers, and underscores, no spaces, not be longer than 63 characters, and a number cannot be the first character. After tagging everything you want, download the new userdata.json file and put it inside your models folder in the VTube Studio directory, replacing the original JSON file if necessary. If you want to then use these tags in CheersBot, you will go to your CheersBot control panel, go down to add a new color tint. If you want to affect specific art meshes, you will change it to specific art meshes under type. And then you can then add in your tags. And then if you didn't know, you can actually use the color to change your opacity down to zero, which will effectively allow you to make certain objects invisible on your model, which could be helpful to set up things like bald mode or any visibility toggles on your model that don't have actual parameters on your model set up. But I hope this helps, and if you have any questions about the VTube Studio tagger or about CheersBot, you can join Hawkbar's Discord server, which I will link in the description.